Hello, I'm Daria Fissoun, and today we'll be looking at the false color scope. The information covered in this video will be applicable across any hardware or application that features a false color mode, but I'll also be focusing on some elements that are unique to OmniScope. Let's get started. The false color scope is a graphic representation of the various value ranges of an image. Most commonly, it is used to represent luminance, but it can also be mapped to show saturation levels, or hues. It's called false color because a set of arbitrary colors are assigned to represent sections of image values, which makes it easier to distinguish where specific values appear in the frame. We use false color to evaluate the overall exposure of a scene and spot over or under exposure. We use it to verify that skin tones fall within a predefined, usually mid-tone range. And we can also use it to match exposure or skin tones across shots for continuity. DPs use false color to achieve consistent scene contrast, for example, by monitoring the ratio between the key and fill light. Right-click in the false color scope to reveal the contextual menu. The presets option allows you to map the colors based on industry standard false color presets. You could choose colors and ranges that might already be familiar to you in your work as a camera operator or editor. Or you can simply choose a preset because it feels intuitive to your workflow. Underneath the presets, you'll find a couple of modes. Always stretch video signal to full will apply a video to full range conversion to the signal and map the false colors accordingly. Keep in mind that OmniScope already automatically detects your color space and signal levels, so you only need to activate this option if you are deliberately outputting video levels and wish to see them interpreted as full. Beneath that, you also have the ability to hide the scale in the scope window. This will give you an unobstructed view of the frame, and it's a great option if you've been working with false colors long enough to be familiar with what each color band represents. There are a few ways you can interact with the source signal viewer and the other scopes when working in the false color window. Drag in the viewer to isolate that section. This works both ways. Hold Shift and drag to keep that selection in place until your next click. This will allow you to study a section of the image more closely across multiple scopes while grading. The false color scope is highly customizable. When you open the settings window, you can use the on-screen scale controls to define your own ranges and colors to best accommodate your workflow. You can drag a percentage marker to adjust the range section, or click within the scale to add a new range. This will create a new marker and automatically assign a color to that range. When you select the marker, you reveal additional controls. Here, you can change the range color and transparency. Click Grayscale to turn the area directly above or below the marker gray, and select whether the transition to the next marker will be a gradient or a solid with a sharp edge. To remove a range section, middle-click its marker. To save your false color layout, right-click in the viewer, go to Presets, and choose Save Preset. Here, you can also load presets that you or your collaborators have previously created. To reset the false color viewer, either right-click and choose Reset Settings, or return to the Presets drop-down and reload the preset you need. Let's take a look at a few more controls. Drag the Opacity slider to change the transparency of the false colors, revealing the original image underneath. Drag Blur to soften the edges of the color ranges in the scale and viewer. Enable Compact Mode to reduce the width of the scale in the viewer, giving more real estate to the image you're working on. The Mode drop-down allows you to select the image component that will be displayed in the scope. By default, it is set to project standard dynamic range luminance, but you can also choose HDR, which will map the false colors to a 10,000 nit luminance range. Use the Mastering Level slider underneath to select the actual nit range that you'll be working in, and the SDR white level drop-down to select its distribution relative to SDR. You have two options when mapping false colors to saturation levels. In both cases, you might find that switching to the saturation preset will make it easier to monitor the readout. The first saturation option is appropriate for most images with natural colors. The top color, which is red by default, indicates areas of high saturation. The next color represents areas with 50% saturation. And after that, the scale fades to zero opacity, meaning pixels with little to no saturation will appear unaffected in the viewer. The second saturation mode is more sensitive and is designed for signals with flatter or more subtle colors. Use it to spot areas of high saturation relative to the rest of the image. Hue mode will map all the colors on the spectrum from red at the top to violet at the bottom and assign the false colors accordingly. This mode can be helpful when trying to reach or match target hues, like when working with corporate colors. Create a new range in the scale to find the exact hue you wish to highlight, and then try to match the appearance of that object in subsequent shots to that same range. When working in luminosity mode, you reveal the scale parameter dropdown, which features a list of universal waveform scope scales. Match the scale type to your waveform and parade scopes for a more direct correlation to their values and to make the false color bands more intuitive. OmniScope now features a dedicated skin tone scope for precise skin matching and beauty work, but you can also combine the false color scope with a skin overlay for the best of both worlds. This feature is similar to one found in Flanders monitors where you can adjust a knob to move the skin tone range up and down on the scale. In OmniScope, your false color scale will also stay in place while you define your own skin tone minimum and maximum range. You can then adjust and match the luminance in every scene while ensuring consistent skin tones across all subjects. Let's look at a few practical examples of the false color scope in action. In this shot, it's hard to tell from the image alone if the highlights are safe or blown out. I'm going to enable Loop in the View menu to get a magnified look at the detail. According to the false color scope, which is currently set to the RE preset, the snowy surface of this mountain is either clipping or very close to it. I'm going to use the specular wheel in DaVinci Resolve HDR palette to drop the exposure on the upper range of the image, reducing the intensity of the highlights and bringing detail back into the mountain. When it comes to matching, I'll keep an eye on the false color scope while comparing two images in the same sequence. Notice how the darkest parts of the second mountain shot are not as dark as the ones in the opening one, despite there being far more shadows. I'll reduce the lift of the second image until I see some of the black false color in the darkest parts of the mountains, which will match the shadows and contrast of the two shots. In this sequence, we have a group of people facing the sun. Their skin is well lit at the front, but in deep shadow on the opposite side. If we want to match their skin in a sequence, we will want to see a similar transition of the false colors in sequential clips. This follow-up shot was captured later in the day with less exposure. The highlighted area on the man's forehead is smaller, and the shadows are much deeper than in the preceding shot. By raising the gain, I can match the exposure levels on his face, resulting in a more consistent sequence. I hope this video has given you a good overview of the many things you can do in the false color scope. Remember to check out the description below to get the official documentation on the Time and Pixels website. And please give this video a like if you found it helpful. Follow this channel to be informed when new tutorials are released and to hear future OmniScope announcements.